ברוך אתה אדוני אלוהינו מלך העולם שהכל נהיה בדברו. מרבה רבותיי, first of all, thank you very much for coming once again to Monday night, the gate of trust, the duty of the heart. Today the topic is one word that can change your life. באמת, one word that can change a person's life. But just before the topic, I just came back from Askara. Yeshuva. Not Askara, I'm sorry, funeral. I just came out from funerals. And I understand that the person that passed away, it was an age of 58 or something.
62.
62? Okay, they told me 58. 58 and 62, very young age. And, you know, maybe today we're going to discuss about something that is important to all of us. And maybe the only guarantee to have a long and healthy life. למען יאריכון ימיך ולמען יטב לך. What is the guarantee that a person can have? And today we're going to explain why. That a person can have a long and healthy life. Mordechai just came in the right times. You know, this is a priceless advice. You know, one of the greatest mitzvot, and we said last, maybe 2 weeks ago, 3 weeks ago, that this mitzvah we received before Matan Torah. This is one of the 3 mitzvot that we received before Matan Torah. Which mitzvah? We received 3 things, 3 items before Matan Torah. One of them is business, or law, chukim, that a person have to know, have to follow the laws, and not to find the crooked ways. You know, I'm talking about not stealing, not cheating, even though there's a great opportunity outside. But at the end of the day, the person has to remember that nobody ever gained from stealing. And the short, in the short run, in the short run might be you made few pack, few $100, few $1,000s, sometimes even $50,000, $100,000 in the short run. But there's no wondering why some people lost all the money after 10 or 10, 20 years. My older brother always used to say, Midah keneged midah. When God challenged a person and items that happened to him, he have to check in that items what exactly did wrong. So if a person lose money, he have to ask what exactly happened with the money that God punished him in a way to lose it. Most likely, teshuvah have to be made with the money himself. Either lack of charity, or either the money came in unkosher ways. When I say unkosher, Shabbat. When I say unkosher, stealing, finding a ways to take. It's no blessing in the end of the days. Not only that, we study that a person obligated to get himself to the courthouse. Ladies and gentlemen, and I'm happy that I speak in front of thousands and thousands via the internet, we're not allowed to go to a civil courthouse. This is against halacha. Let's make it simple. If I have something against you or you have something against me, they have a religious courthouse that called Beit Din. The only place that one Jew is taking another Jew is to Beit Din. And only Beit Din can give authorization to go to the regular, to the civil courthouse. You're not allowed without permission, this is a pseudo writer, to go in to a regular courthouse. Why? Because they are not religious. They don't think so alike. There's many, many difference. So God gave us a different rules and regulations. The first mitzvah that God gave us when we left Egypt, before Matan Torah, is to follow his own rules and regulations that belong to us. Chukim, dinim, u'mishpatim that belong to us. Okay, this one. Second mitzvah is keeping Shabbat. We all know that keeping Shabbat is one of the greatest mitzvot. And last but not least, because of that, Shabbat is the blessing of everything. Because of that, you know, the rabbi always tell you, everything that you need, refuah, long life, healthy life, getting married, anything you need, ki mineh mitbarchim, from the Shabbat, all the 6 days, is being blessed. By the way, just if I remember, maybe the Chida Kadosh writes, that the secret of Shabbat is this one. When God created the world, ki sheshet yamim asa, God made this world, Sarah, how many days? 6 days. ביום השביעי שבת ואין נפש. באמת חזל אומרים, if not for the sin of the forbidden fruit that Adam and Eve did, the world was supposed to end in the 7 days. God created the world only for 7 days. It was no gazanin for the other days. So where the other days came from? After the sin, what is the gazanin for the next 6 days? The Shabbat in between. Shabbat is the power and the blessing. Ki minei mitbarchim kereshon HaZohar. The Zohar HaKadosh Ha'id, from Shabbat, the next 6 days is being blessed. So if you had a tough week, ask yourself what exactly went wrong in Shabbat. Instead of sleeping too much, maybe you have to come to the tefillah much earlier. Maybe you have to spend a little more time to study Torah. Maybe the Shmirat Shabbat himself, you have to study more halachot. The way that you cooked, what you're allowed to say, what you're not allowed to say, many details in Shabbat. But last but not least, and this is the topic of today, Kibud Hurim, honoring your father and mother. When I was there, they invited me to speak. I said, you know, I'm going to share with you two things. First of all, respecting of your parents never end. Never end. Meaning, not when they are alive, and especially after death. By the way, the Gemara said, Gadol kibud hurim b'motu yoter me'asher b'chayav. Meaning, respecting your parents after they die is even greater from before. Why is it even greater? You know, this statement is a bold statement. Very tough statement to hear, so I'm like, why? And the answer is very simple. When they are alive, usually they don't need us. Usually we need them for money, for advice, for everything. Only when they are niftarim, then they need us. Because the only way to go above and above in heaven is when your own child is doing Shurei Torah, Kaddish, Kedusha. For everything that the child is doing, he affects the life that the father cannot do anymore. As long that you are here, you have ability to change your life. But from the minute that a person dies, how did the Pasuk said, "Bamitim chofshi"? A dead man become a free man. Free in which sense? Chofshi min ha-mitzvot. He is free to do mitzvot. You're not going to see a dead man put in tefillin, talit. Because of that, when you're walking into a cemetery, the first thing that you do is what? You hide the tzitzit. Why do you have to hide the tzitzit? The reason is not to embarrass the dead man. I am better from you. I can wear tzitzit and you're not. This is the only reason that when we're going into tzitzit, you're not praying next to a grave. Not because you're not praying to the graves. Nobody suspects you to pray to graves. We pray to the Almighty God. You're not praying because it's like you're telling the dead man, I am better from you. I can pray, you cannot. I have Shacharit, I can say Amen, I can say Kaddish, I can say Kedusha, but you are not. Yes, yes, only Kaddish. Yes, Kaddish definitely. Because this is for the benefits of the Niftar. Anything that is benefits of the Niftar, definitely yes. Do you read that? This is the reason. So when David HaMelech was dying, he came into his own child, Shlomo, and said, Shlomo, Hine Anuchi Olech. I'm walking on the way that everybody is walking. Shlomo is looking, the whole world is asking, what's when you're walking? You're going to die. Which walking? A minute before David finished his life, he's telling his own child, what did Gemara answer? Bera Kera De Avua. Meaning, a child, Shimon, is like a leg of his father. As long as the child is walking, the father is walking with him. But David HaMelech told Shlomo, Shlomo, I'm not dead. It's all according to your actions. If you're going to follow the footsteps of God, I will continue to walk. I will walk from one place to heaven, to another place, and the greater there. Kibud Hurim never end. But the question is why? What is so special about honoring your parents? I will give you today 4 different explanations. The first thing is the question that we ask, why Kibud Hurim is on the right side of the tablet and is not left side? Logic-wise, Kibud Hurim is between us to God, us to our parents, us to humans. What is on the right side is usually between us and God. Do not carry the name of God for in vain. Keep the Shabbat. Don't create idols. Remember that God is your God. Every items in the right side of the tablet speaking about relationship ben Adam l'makom. So what Kibudurim is doing there? One explanation is very simple. A parents, they are a partner of God. And as long that you respect the parents, ma'ale alav ha-katuv ki'ilu ki'benani. Every time you respect your father or your mother, consider to be like you respect the Almighty God. Be'emet, the Gemara said that the goyim yuducha Hashem kol malchei aretz. You know what's the meaning? Dr. Daniel, when exactly the goyim grace or bless the Almighty God? When they heard the names, when they heard the commitment of the Ten Commandments, it was, you know, they were kept quiet. But only one commandment, they said, God, you are great. Even the goyim said, in this moment, the whole world stood up and clapped their hands and said, this God is the greatest God. When he said, Kabed et avicha ve et imecha. Why? So the Gemara said very simple, you know why? Because a normal king, what a normal king is supposed to say? Respect me. It's all about me. I, me, and myself. When God said honoring human beings, honor your father and mother, they realize that the Almighty God is different from any other idols. Any other idols doesn't care for nobody except himself. God cares for the kavod of others. Yoducha Hashem kol malchei aretz. In this moment they admit that the Torah is a myth. Do you hear that? What a beautiful insight is that? The Gemara said, the Aradak, explain like that. What is the meaning, kabed et avicha ve'et imecha? What is the definition of kavod? My brother today told me a few explanations, and listen to this one. The first one is the Aradak. I want all of us to fulfill one mitzvah, and be'emet, honestly speaking, we don't have to wait until our parents will be dead to memorize them, to respect them, to speak highly about them. Maybe it's a good time for all of us to do teshuvah when they are alive and to give the highest kavod when they are still with us. Ladies and gentlemen, you are lucky people. You know why you are lucky? Because I say it with a, I don't know how to call it, a broken heart. But what I'm telling you today, the only time that I saw my father was in the hospital, because I was stuck here in America for 12 years because of immigration reasons. I was not allowed to leave the countries until the green card and all this nonsense came out. The lawyer told me, do not leave. So for 12 years, I didn't see my father when he was healthy and everything was amazing. The only time I saw my father was the last 2 years of his life when he was in the hospital. You are so lucky that you can see your parents every day. They live next to you. You can come and visit. I believe that maybe last week I told you the Lubavitcher Rebbe, when his mother was here, when his mother came, she came out from Russia. The last 20 years of her life, she was living here, Rabbanit Chana. She was living here in the States. The Rebbe, the most busy human being in the Jewish history, or maybe in the whole world nowadays, having 5,500 messengers, thousands of people waiting, every second of his day is captured. He didn't miss one day to stop for a cup of tea to drink with his mother. Every day he used to walk into the house of his mother from the 770, sitting down with his mother, speak with her. And not only that, one of the messengers that used to take the Rebbe, he saw that the Rebbe moved strange. He moved strange in the way that every time he leaves the tables, he's going strange, like he's fixing the tables. He asked. He didn't ask. His mother, the mother saw that he saw it. So the mother explained to this Hasid. She said, I will explain what my son is doing. My son fixed the table because he thinks that I don't know. He never put his back on his mother. So in order not to put, he was moving chairs to make sure that his back is like, you know, some rabbanim, they have a tradition not to put the backs to Aron HaKodesh, or not to put the backs to Sefer Torah, when you have Sefer Torah, not to go this way, not to stand up when Sefer Torah is behind you. It's kind of chutzpah, lack of respect. The Rebbe never put his back to his mother. What a high level of kibbudurim, what a high level. Dr. Daniel, I'm so happy that your mother is here today. Maybe this is the reason I'm speaking about it. Baruch Hashem. But you're going to see what's the reward. One second. Rabotai, the Radak explained, what is the meaning, Kabed et avicha ve timecha leman erhun emecha? Kabed hakavana deag letzorchem umilui mishalotam. Honoring your parents meaning care for everything that they need and for everything that they wish. Be there for their wish and for their needs. This is your job being a child, to be there for your parents. And the second, understand why? One of the simple reasons we're going to see is appreciation, akaratatov for everything that they did in our life. Rashi writes on this pasuk, kabed et avicha ve et imecha. Listen to what Rashi writes. What's the continuing of the pasuk? Mordechai, kabed et avicha ve et imecha, leman yarun imecha, leman itavlach. Honoring your parents in order that you're going to have a long life and in order that you're going to have a good life. Kotev Rashi, this is a condition. If you respect them, you're going to have a long life. And if not, God forbid, I will not continue. If you're going to respect them, you're going to have a good life. But if not, this is not a privilege. You know what? If I will respect, I'm going to have. If not, nothing happened. No, Rashi right is kind of condition. Every time the pasuk said leman, is not only for the sake. It's condition on the mitzvah, and the mitzvah is very simple. You respect your parents, you have guarantee. Not to be chutzpan, not to raise your voice, not to bring horrible comments. What do you know? We are not in Bukhara 2018. Now we are 2018. We're not in Bukhara anymore. All this nonsense have to go away from us. Because everything that we have, spirituality and physically, is because of our parents. And this is the emet. You have to understand if you like it or not. Your whole being here is because of your parents. So definitely, you want to have a long life? You will never lose, the Gemara said. For honoring your father. Sometimes you said, but I'm losing times, I'm losing days, every time you're going to visit. It's at times. When your parents is with you, you're losing hours of sleeping sometime. And the answer is, the Gemara said, this is the reason, Mordechai, you get blessed in a long life. Why? Because that extra years is for the years that you lost because of your parents. You never lose from doing business with God. Maybe doing business with human beings, you lose all day long. You gain, you lose, ups and downs. But when you're doing a business with God, you never lose. You're not going to lose the years, you're not going to lose the days, just the opposite. I will increase the days of life. This is what's meaning honoring your parents. Come, Unculus. And Unculus explain in a profound way. What does it mean, Kabed? Yekar et avicha. Yekar, what does it mean yekar? Precious. Make him yekarim. Not simple people. They are the most precious people that exist. You know, you don't mention your parents in the end. You give them the first kavod. When your parents coming in, there's no doubt that you have to stand up from your chairs and give it to your parents. The same way that if the President of the United States is going to come to you, you're going to give him the highest kavod, the highest respect, the same way and even more is your parents. Kabed meaning yakar, meaning teyaker otam. Like gold, like diamonds, like a precious items. Lama, mazel leman, bedil. You know what means bedil? What's mean bedil? Bedil is offeret, you know, when you were trying to connect between two items, between two silvers. What do you do? You do offeret. Offeret meaning
welt.
Something.
Welt.
Exactly.
Together.
Exactly. Have to,
welt.
Welt. That welt is bedil. What you have to do with kibudurim? Very simple. A job of a child is to connect between his father and mother. This is the job of a child. But come Unculus and said, what is your job? Is to connect between your parents. meaning to be. You know, sometimes children, they can make such a fight, such an argument, running from one parent, telling the parents what the mother said, what the father said. They call it in English or in Bukharian, jangonozi. Even between the children, they have jangonozi. Yes, some children, they are expert to share information. Ima, don't tell Abba, but you know what Abba said about you? He said like that, when he was upset, I don't hold him in the phones. Your job is to connect the parents, not to disconnect. Your job is to get your parents closer, and that's distance-wise. Even though that you don't agree, don't make issues in Shalom Bayit. Even in your own Shalom Bayit, in your own home, between your father and mother. You see what Onkelos listened? A simple word. Onkelos again. Onkelos is the one that explains everything. You're going to see when you open the Chumash, you're going to see Rashi, one side, and Onkelos, and the other. This is in Aramaic. He gave a simple, look like he's just given word by word, but he's not. He said, Natan, meaning you have. What do you mean you have? What do you mean you have? You have meaning, listen to this one. You have meaning, Ashlecha Hashem Yahavcha, Vehu Yechalkelecha. Throw in God Yahavcha. The Gemara says, what is Yahavcha? Masa. You know what I mean, Masa? Masa, when you carry something heavy, you have to throw it away. Anything that you have heavy on your shoulders, you have to throw it to God and don't worry. God will carry the weight. You know that famous mashal, famous explanation that Chafetz Chaim writes. He writes like that, listen to this one. The Chafetz Chaim writes, mashal emad avad omen. He was once to, how do you call it, a backpacker? The one that going into the east, or, you know, the one that taking, how do you call it? Backpacker, yes, okay. Metainim, terminalim, they call it in Hebrew. They took the, you know, huge bag, huge. You know how heavy is that? Because everything that they need is in the bag. Clothing, nothing, they don't take luggage. You're going into to the east, you're going into, you have to take, everything is in it. It's so heavy. They walk in, they got so tired. They saw, they decide to look for a ride. They saw once in a blue moon, a car is passing. Now they saw a car, they do this way, please, they look like this, begging, the car stop. He said, okay, you can sit down. They sitting down, and they still sitting with the back. The driver, after 5 minutes, said, excuse me, sir, excuse me, guys. Why do you wear still the bag? Why do you wear it with you? He said, no, we want to make it easy on you. That is not going to be heavy. He said, I don't understand. I'm already taking you with your bag. So just leave it down, it's really free, is it normal? Why do you have to carry? This is the same way that we are acting with God. God carry with us. God carry us. But we still have worries. I don't understand all your worries. Already God carry. God carry you and your worries. So just let the worry leave. Take the masa, the burden from yourself away. This is one explanation. But listen to the other explanation according to Kibud Orim. Go and listen to this one. My brother explained in a beautiful way. You know what mean? Masa? Masa meaning, don't act with your parents like they are a burden on you. You see, many times we respect our parents, but the way that we do it is like, you know, the father or the mother feel that the children wish that we're going to be gone. The way that you do it with so much faces and sour face and everything that they ask you have to take a few days of preparation. And you know, sometimes a father asks something from a child and he says, you know what? It's better I never ask him that. Every time I ask, I need anything from pharmacists. You know, Baruch Hashem, we have many students. There are pharmacists, dentists. You know, in 1 or 2 hours, I see all the medicine in my house. And they don't even charge me. If your parents ask you the same, are you going to act so fast? Or your parents, no, I'm going to come at night. Until tomorrow, nothing happens if you don't have it. If your parents ask you for a favor, or ask you for something, do you give them to feel burden, or you do it with happiness? Come on, Onkelos, and said, respecting your father and mother meaning make them precious. Make them precious. And when you give it to them, don't give it to them like you're making favor. Give it to them like they're making favor with you. Ashlecha Hashem Yahavcha. Yahav meaning masa, burden. carrying heavy items, throw it away. Throw it away meaning respect with dignity. Give them to feel that they are the most unique and you are the most privileged. But why the kibbutzim is so important? Well, Rabotai, I will say it in a simple way. There's many explanations. One of them is a karatat of, yes, appreciation. Appreciation that your parents pay their tuition, change your diapers. I'm sorry to go details. Go the extra mile to put food on your tables, clothing, anything you wish and desires, you got. It's amazing. But I admit, Mordechai, we're so lucky to have such a parent. I admit, everything that we have is because your father, Rahmat Kulam, and your mother. Tibedelechem Tovim Barukim. This is the admit, right, Uriel? Your father, Rahmat Kulam, and your mother. Tibedelechem Tovim Barukim. Ezrat Hashem. That your mother will always going to have tears, but tears of happiness. Tears of your weddings and your brother's wedding, Avraham Bezrat Hashem, Hashanah, Hashanah Bezrat Hashem, Hashanah, you know, I'm going to see your mother with so many tears, but happy tears Bezrat Hashem. Why not? She deserves it. Every time you give them the kavod, you have to feel so lucky and so worldly. This kibud orim is one of the only guarantees to have a long and a happy life. You want to have a secret for a long life, for a happy life, very simple. Remember, honoring your parents. Give them to feel that they are the most unique and special people in your life. How many times, you know, I hear my mom, and everything that she says, I always say, Ima, you're right, 100% right. But I met, how come I didn't thought about it? Brilliant ideas. And even though that sometimes, I'll be honest, I'm speaking in English, this way my mom will never understand. It's good for me. I'm not always agree. But that agreement has to do with myself. What your mother speak, I always say, you're right, 100%. Ima, this is the greatest advice that you ever given to me. My mother had a dream that I'm going to be a doctor, a lawyer, psychology, successful rich man. This is, you know, she's struggling in life. She wants us to have. Actually, she didn't succeed, none of us. She didn't succeed not even one child. They all open him. It's amazing. I know, in your eyes, you look amazing. You know, wow, Baruch Hashem. You know, she, okay. But until now, I said, Ima, you know what? If I went to business, it was a whole different life. But I admit, you're right. I didn't have to struggle. It was my Baruch Hashem, everything. It's okay. Yes, indeed. I'm the most lucky person. And my mother told me, one day she told me, I'm so happy that you in this job that you work in, being a rabbi. Why? Because first of all, it's not a job, it's a way of life. This is the only items that is not a job. It's not 8 to 4. 4 o'clock, that's it, I finished to be a rabbi. That's it. Now I can go outside and... No. Rabbi is a rabbi 24/7, so it's not a job. It's a way of life. And second, I see that you're so happy and satisfied in life. And that one money cannot buy. But you know what? Sometimes she reminds me that it's good to be a businessman, it's good to do this, it's good to buy houses, or you don't invest. It's an amazing idea, but you need money to invest. Right, Jim, you need money then. But the matter is, a person always have to respect. Always have to respect his parents. The way that you speak, the way that you cherish them. Is that, but you know why? Not only because appreciation, mainly because they are a partner of God. You know what it means by being a partner of God? God had the desires. And what's the desires of God? The tunnel is to have you in this world. This is the desire of God. How that I saw beautiful statements. And the day that I came to the world, God decides that the world cannot be exist without me. I love these statements. Each one of us here, because God decides that the world cannot be without you. You are important and crucial to this world. To make this world complete without you is not going to be the same. So it's amazing, right? But who is the one that brought you physically wise? Your parents. And instead of being selfishness, and not having children, and today become a little popular, you hear more and more people that literally choose not to have children. Because of the career, because they want to see the world, because they want to go around, they want to spend the money, because they don't need the headaches. How many times do you hear people, no, children is headaches, children is this. Your parents stop their life and their visions and their dreams in order that you're going to have a life. You know what you mean to have a child? Only when you have one you understand. Where you stop everything that you ever desires and dreams in order to stop everything and to care for your own child. From the minute that he came to the world until the minute that he's going to leave the world, 120 years, your life is going to be hold for their needs. This is what parents, this is a partner of God. They brought the vision of God to reality, and they did everything to make sure that this reality will become who you are today. You're respecting your parents because of appreciation, hakarat hatov, but you're respecting your parents also because they are partner of God. Partner of God of bringing you, partner of God for sacrificing their life in order that you're going to be here. This is the greatest level that you can have. If this is so, let's all of us accept in ourselves one great mitzvah. Maybe the greatest. Kibud Hurim. The Gemara said that Rabbi Tarfon, when his mother used to walk in the shuk, in the market, one day the shoes ripped off. You know what Rabbi Tarfon did? He went down and he put the hand on the floors. The Gemara said on this, Dama Benetina, the Gemara, one of the most famous stories in Kibud Hurim, listen to this. Somebody come to you and offer you $100,000 profit. And the key of the safe deposit, where is the diamond, is when your mother, under the pillow of your mother. Are you going to wake your mother or not going to wake? Is even any questions? Rabbi, for $1,000, my mother is going to be jumping. For $100,000, the whole neighborhood is going to be jumping. I'm not going to wake. This guy didn't wake his father. He's a goy. Dama Benatina. Because he didn't want him. He said, listen, if you need it badly, come after hours. Gezel Shana. I'm not going to wake up. The Gemara said in Yerushalmi, even better story, listen to the stories. His mother of this guy, the father was normal, the mother was cuckoo. The mother used to come to him, and she came with the shoes, beating his face, beating. In front of all the, he was a rich man, he was a very respectable person. In front of all the community, the board, she started to beat him. Now she got so tired, the shoes fell down. You know what the guy said? He took the shoes, he gave it back to his mama. He said, Dima, you didn't finish it. This is the level of Kibud Hurim. The Gemara said that everything that the Christian world have, and the Muslims as well, is because of one mitzvah. The Muslims have the Brit Milah as well. But except that, which mitzvah? Kibud Hurim. All the diamonds and all the monies and all the wealth that they have is only because of one mitzvah of Esav. The way that Esav used to respect his parents, he never came where a simple clothing. Every time he came into the house of his mother, he used to wear the Begdei Shabbat. That Begadim that Yaakov Avinu changed, you remember the clothing? Why did he change the clothing? Why so important? Because Esav never saw his father without this clothing. He was kind of respect. It's like when you come into Shabbat, you don't come with jeans, you don't come with simple t-shirt, you come with a white shirt, you come respectable. The same way, every time he's going in to see his parents. Do you hear that? What's the level of Kibud Hurim? Yes, the message might be already mentioned. But gentlemen, everything that we have, ladies, is because of our parents. This is the emet. I will end with one word that can change life. One word that you need to know. And that word is Amen. Why did they say Amen? So in Shabbat we gave explanation, and I want everybody to hear it once again. To engrave it. How important it is to say Amen. I'm not remember if it was Rabbi Abuav, or maybe Rabbi Abuav went in. One rabbi went in to one of the greatest tzaddikim, and he was there, and the child said, Bore Pirech. And the rabbi was busy studying, and he didn't respond Amen. You know what the rabbi did to these students? He made them in cherem for 40 days. He didn't spoke with them for 40 days. Why? He left the blessing without answering the men. A student went into his rabbi to study something, and the child of the rabbi said beracha, and the guy didn't answer amen. Nothing, he was busy. The rabbi pushed him away for 40 days. Even though that he was a giant, he was a righteous man. He said, I don't accept him. I don't remember the names right now. But the message is, the Kafa Chaim writes that the person have to go the extra miles. Not to say beracha if you don't have nobody to answer amen. If you have a cup of water that you want to drink and you can hold yourself, don't drink the water.
Who did he push away, the son or the man?
The student that didn't say amen. You see, the story is like that. They said that you don't wait with the water, wait with the apples, wait with the tomato, wait with the blessing, shakul, boy plate, adama, wait with that. Why? Wait for amen. Why so important about amen? Very simple. It's three different explanations. The first one is, amen complete the blessing. What's amen complete the blessing? I will give you two side points. One side point is, amen is the signature. Now, Shimon, what is more important? To have a check for $50,000 with no signature, or to have a check with $1,000 with signature?
$1,000 signature.
Very nice. Because no signature, the check doesn't equal zero. You can have $1 million. If it's no signature, if you have $1,000 with signature, the check worth $1,000. The amen is the signature of the blessing. Because of that, Chazal said, Gadol ha'one amen, yoter me'amevarech. Greater is the one that answers in amen, much greater from the one that blessing. One reason. Second reason is, if you're going to realize, any blessing in the books, any blessing is 9 words. Baruch Ata Hashem, Elokeinu Melech HaOlam, Shehakol Nihya Bedvaro. How many? 9. Baruch Ata Hashem, Elokeinu Melech HaOlam, Borei Peri Adam. How many? 9. Baruch Ata Hashem, Elokeinu Melech HaOlam, Borei Peri Aetz. How many? 9. Shehakol Nihya Bedvaro. If you're going to go, any blessing in the books except the Motzi is 9 words. Why 9? Because Amen is number 10. And we know that number 10 is very important. Number 10 is when the Shekhinah is coming. Number 10 is when the blessing is arriving.
The
Shekhinah meaning the godliness, the blessing of God. Do you hear that? Number 10, what makes the blessing complete is not only signature. This is the reason it's a signature. It's number 10. Another reason. You know why Amen is important? Because Amen, you see, when you say Baruch Ata Hashem, how do we say the blessing? Baruch Ata Amunai. Amunai is my master. Master is not always a merciful one. Master can be also judgment, right? Your master, when you say, you are my master, he is my master, meaning you are what? You are what? A slave. If it's slave is not in a good position. Slave is not in a good, right? Slave is not in a good position. How do you take a blessing that brings in the judgment of God and your sweetness to be sweet, to be kind, to be only blessing and no judgment? You know how? By saying amen. Why? Why? You see?